In the name of Allah, the Compassionate, the Merciful. Good morning, my dear students, and welcome to your science class. I hope you all are good in health and are enjoying your online classes. Today we are going to start the second lesson of week 8. In the previous lesson, we discussed the matter in detail. I told you that there are three states of matter. We compared three states of matter. I also told you about the arrangement of particles, their movement, the distance between them and forces of attraction between the particles of solids, liquids and gases. Today we are going to continue the same unit, which is unit number 7, matter and the water cycle. The topic for today's discussion is changes of states. We are going to discuss the following changes in states: melting, freezing, condensation, evaporation and sublimation. Let's start now. Look at this diagram. It explains all the processes of changes in states of matter. You can see clearly that when a solid changes into the liquid, the process is called melting. When a solid changes directly into a gas, the process is called sublimation. The change of a liquid into a gas is called vaporization or evaporation. The change from gas to a liquid state is condensation, while liquid to solid is called freezing. These are all the processes which change the states of matter. Now we will discuss all these changes in detail with the help of word equations and examples. The first process which changes the state of matter is melting. Melting can be defined as the change of a solid state of matter into a liquid state on heating. You can see in the given word equation that when a solid absorbs heat, it changes into a liquid. Melting ice cubes, melting ice cream and melting candle wax are the examples of this process. All these involve the absorption of heat. The next process is freezing. A liquid changes into a solid when it is cooled. This process is called freezing. Look at the word equation. It shows that when a liquid loses heat, it changes into a solid. Examples are freezing ice cream and freezing water in the form of crystals of ice in a cold place. A gas changes into the liquid when it is cooled. This process is called condensation. The word equation shows that when a gas loses heat, it changes into a liquid. We observe condensation in our daily life as shown in the given pictures. The next process is evaporation. A liquid changes into gas when it absorbs heat from its surrounding. This process is called evaporation. The equation explains that when a liquid absorbs heat, it changes into a gas. The picture shows the process of evaporation, where water is converted into steam on heating. Process of sublimation is very interesting. When a solid changes into a gas without becoming a liquid first, the process is called sublimation. In this process, heat is absorbed by the solid and the solid directly converts into a gas. It happens to a few substances. One of the rare examples is carbon dioxide gas. It does not change into the liquid but directly converts into a gas on heating. Now let me share your homework with you. I want you all to watch this video again and revise the processes of change in states of matter. Read your textbook page number 65 and 66 and complete the given worksheet. I will see you next week. Till then, take care of yourself. Goodbye.